Alright guys, what is up? This is Croy1176. How's everybody doing today? Alright, so I've been speaking to Derek, the guy from the church, and I actually sent him this mix that I just came up with to help him out with his church project, to paint the screen, all that stuff. He's the guy that has Kenneth Bird's Black 38 Widow, whatever, right? So he sent me the video and given me input on that mix. That mix has nothing to do with my mixes that I'm selling. It's just something I came up with and I sent it to him just to test out, okay? Just be aware of that. But one thing that I want you guys to see, man, it's crazy, because if you see the mix that I send them, it's really light. I mean, it's lighter than the black thing that Kenneth Bird created, right? It's way lighter. You will see, he's going to be painting it. He's going to be talking about it. It's kind of a lengthy video, but really informative. So just look through it, you know, where he's painting. You can skip that a little bit, but it's really informative. But check out the different tones, from a gray to the black, and the results, right? So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to send them the Cinemax. That's my next thing, just a little sample so you could test it out next. But the mix that he has right now is just something I came up with, just to see, you know, give me an idea of what he wants, right? But I think the Cinemax, I think, man, that it's gonna work for him. I hope so. Let's see what happens. But check out the video. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about it. And enjoy, man. I'll see you guys later. Like always, save hundreds. Peace.
All right, so this is Derek again with a another quick video for Crow. He sent me a small sample of some of his screen paint mix that he's been working on, so we're gonna try that. I decided, instead of just using like I don't know, like those vinyl cutout things or the little signage things that you can buy like Walmart, I decided to try, these are 20 by 24, babe, what would you call these? Canvas. 20 by 24 canvas, like a paint canvas I got at Walmart, and they're like two in a pack for like $16. I'm gonna go ahead and prime them, even though I probably don't need to, but I'm gonna err on the side of caution. Just to make sure I've got a good layer on here so like nothing seeps through the canvas material. I don't think it will, because these are already made to where that won't happen, but I'm gonna go ahead and prime it. I've got Sherwin-Williams multi-purpose latex primer. So I won't really show, I'll show like a little bit after I'm done like painting them, but I've got a small nap roller that I'm gonna use. It's a really, really good quality, so it should be pretty smooth, turn out really well. I'm gonna go ahead and prime both these, and then once these have dried, I'll probably come back like another day and start another video, and I'll do one of these with Crow's paint that he sent, and then the other one with the leftover paint that I have from Crystal Edge, Kenneth. I'm gonna put his on one, and then I'll take both these 20 by 24s up to the church where I originally filmed the other video, and put those up against our just white generic projector screen and the Epson laser printer. And I promise next time I come back on the video, I'll know what the model number is. But it's an Epson laser printer. I've been talking printers all day with my wife. It's a laser projector, 3 LCD, really bright, 6,000 lumen. It's an excellent projector. But we'll put it up against that, and we'll see how it does. So I'll be back here in a few minutes once I've got these primed. All right, so both canvases are now primed. I know it's obviously, I'm painting white on white, so you can't tell or really see in any of the video. But anyway, they both have a fresh coat of primer on. So I'm gonna let these dry overnight. Probably tomorrow I'll come back and paint them with the screen paint from Crow and from Crystal Edge, And then the following day, hopefully, it's a Wednesday night for me, so I'll be up at the church anyway. They'll be hopefully be dried and cured, and then we'll take them up there and see what they look like. So we'll be back shortly. All right. Hey, everyone. So this is Derek again. Now we're doing the portion of painting these canvases that I got. I apologize for the setup, and then I don't have a tripod or anything for my camera or my phone camera, so I'm just like kind of making do. I'm actually up here at my church inside the garage, but we're gonna go ahead and just record that so anybody watching this can see me do that. The rollers I'm using is the standard nap roller. It's a 3/8 inch nap roller. I don't know if you can see that. And this is, like, granted, I've really only got like Walmart and a couple other places in my town because we're kind of small, but these were like the best ones that I could get, rated best. So I guess take that with a grain of salt. But anyway, I've got a couple more of these. I'm gonna do painting with crow's paint, and then also with let me do this without messing the camera up. There's crow's paint that he sent me. And I've already kind of shaken this up. Let's shake it up a little bit more. And I did pre-open it, but he's got a nice little plastic wrap on the inside so nothing spills out. And then I've got the crystal edge paint, the leftover paint that I had from the other video that I shot. Batch 3422. I had to give them out a good shake too. And there should be enough left to coat this this canvas, and then I've got the other canvas sitting in the background. But anyway, on these nap rollers, I've already like kind of rubbed on them to get the excess lint and felt, or you know, whatever the stuff is made out of, all the extra hairs and whatnot off of it. So hopefully, we won't have any debris inside the paint. So first, I'll go ahead and go with the crystal edge paint. And I will try to do this pretty quick. Oh my gosh, what did I? Can't open this. Oh, here we go. Might have like sealed itself shut with the paint on the side. Probably more than enough. Here we go. Do this without making a mess. Last time I did this on the 91 inch diagonal screen, I was being extra safe and careful, but I still got paint all over me. So stuff does go on pretty well. Little bit can go a long way from the last time that I used it. And again, I did prime these in the other video. I didn't record myself doing that because, you know, it's kind of uneventful, not very exciting, painting white on white. I'm gonna try my best to do like very nice, even rolls, even though I swear I took very good care doing that 91 inch screen, and it still had like streaks and lines in it. Couldn't really see the streaks and lines if you were doing an image or video that had a lot of bright colors in it, or you know, whites. You didn't really see it, but if you did you know, just a static white image, which I showed in that video, our church logo, like the ending to some of the videos, we do it on a solid white background, and it was terrible. Like you could see all the paint roll marks and every even though, like I said, I did extra care to do this right. I guess maybe I could have done a better job, but I thought I did a pretty good job. See, like, you can already tell that there's some streaks in it. And because of the angle that you guys are at, you definitely can't see it, but I can with the light at the angle that I'm at. See if I can get these out. I'll just go real light. Looks a little bit better. And I did see somebody made a comment on the video that I originally did and sent to Crow. Somebody said that Kenneth Bird did a video about my video discrediting everything that I had done or had said, but I tried to go back and look for that video, but I couldn't find that video anywhere. Granted, most of his videos are live stream and they are hours long, and I just don't have the time to watch all that. Okay, I need to pull this off and get a new roller. I'm gonna go and use a little bit more on it just to make sure it's nice and thick. Really did have a lot of hope for this paint, because I guess I just kind of bought into the videos and what was being said and how he was doing the demo on these. I don't know if there was like camera manipulation or he was adjusting the lighting afterwards, but it just really looked like if you were to take some flat black paint and, you know, from Home Depot or Lowe's or Sherwin-Williams, wherever, and just, you know, use that paint and then put an image on it. That's kind of what it looked like after it was all said and done. Like, my image was really dark. And like I said, we've got an Epson 6000 lumen laser projector that gets very, very bright. You know, however, with some of the spotlights that we have, you know, we try to curb some of the ambient light off the screen as much as we can, but, you know, we've just got so much lighting that, and because of how our facility is built, there's just not, I just can't get all of it away. So this seemed like that was going to be a good solution, is that this would help retain the blacks to give you more contrast in your picture, but also still retain the brightness. And he does say on his website that, you know, the whites will go down just a bit, but not so much that it's going to ruin the picture, but it definitely ruined the picture. Okay. Please come up. Getting on me? I'll take that. Okay. So we got that roller. Let's see. Oh yeah, there's some paper towels over here. All
wipe and clean this off. Just make sure we don't get any of the black paint on in crow's paint. Okay. So that's that. Here is the 20 by 24 canvas. See, I'm not worried about doing the edges, but it's on, looks from the camera view, from what I'm looking at. I'm using my front facing camera just so I can see what's, you know, what I'm showing you guys. Looks good, nice and smooth. So I'm going to set this off screen so it can dry. Here's the other canvas that I primed. All right. Did I get that? No, I didn't get that on anything. Put the remaining of crystal edge paint. Now here's crow's paint. Like I said, he's got this little plastic over top of it to help keep it from spilling and shipping. Set this down. Put this in the trash. And get a couple more paper towels for my mess. That already got all the lint and fuzz off of it that I could. Put this on. And now, here we go. Start out just a little bit. Because we've got plenty of it. I don't want to make it too thick. At least not on the first pass. So this obviously is not black, which is gives me hope that this is going to be quite a bit better. Obviously, with a lighter paint, you won't lose your brights or your whites as much. So far, this does seem to be going pretty well. And I think I remember, Kuro, you'd have to correct me, but I think in your email you said that after this cures, it'll darken up just a little bit. Set this right here, because I got paint on the bottom of that, and I don't want it
somebody might want to use that later. So far, this seems to apply pretty well. It is, it's not super thick. I'm kind of thinking that I think I'm probably going to go ahead and let this sit for a little bit and dry, and then go ahead and do another coat, because it does appear to be pretty thin. Not that that's a problem or anything, just may have to do more than one coat, because I can kind of still see through it onto the canvas. Yeah, that looks pretty good. It's nice and even. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop the recording. I apologize, this is going on longer than it probably should, but I definitely wanted everybody to see the whole process for this. So be back in maybe 30-ish minutes or so. Not that I expect this to be fully dry in 30 minutes, but I expect it to be hopefully maybe dry enough where I can go ahead and do another coat. So I'll be right back. Okay, so it's been about 30 minutes or so, and it's not 100% dry, but it's pretty dry. It would still be a little tacky, so we're going to go ahead and do another coat. Quick shake. Surprised I've not got this all over the place, but I'm sure I will. Yeah, it does cure a little darker. You can definitely tell. Probably not bad though. Yeah, I think the second coat will get it. Now on Chris Kenneth's paint, whenever I did that 91-inch screen, I did
do one full coat and then I let it dry a day, and then I did a second coat on it just to be sure that I got it, because it was a pretty big area and I didn't do it as thick as I did that canvas over there that's drying. Liking how this is looking so far. Light passes here. Make sure it's nice and even. I really haven't noticed any streaking or, you know, like heavier spots where, you know, you roll over, you know, your same path on the roller where it leaves a heavy, like a single heavy line. I'm not noticing that. Which gives me a lot of hope that you won't be able to see any streaking in this. Well, it's looking good. I like that. So I think we're going to go with this. Put this cap back on. Get anything on me. So you guys can kind of see that. If you can tell, like I was looking pretty hard. I don't see any apparent streaking or anything. Now, when I am setting these down, I'm setting them like face down, just like, or face up, but flat, on a flat surface. So everything dries evenly. So what it looks like, so I'm going to set it here and stop the video, and then when I come back the next time, which will probably be tomorrow, these both should be plenty dry and cured, and we'll throw them up there on the Epson and see how it does.
All right, so we are back on the next day. Both of these paint canvases have dried and both looking pretty good. You can see though, and it might be fixed with doing maybe another coat or something of the Black Widow, but you can see some of the streaking. I can't really tell if that's just extra paint, like the roller that I kind of like overlapped, and that's what that is, or that might be resolved with another coat. So yeah, but that's kind of what I was experiencing on the 91 inch screen that I did with this paint. It had a lot of streaking in it like that, even though I did like two full coats and let it dry a day apart. So I'll kind of hold up some different angles on this so you can see it. And granted, this is a paint canvas. It's not, it is a little rough because it's a canvas. It's not like, you know, painting an actual screen or a projector screen for that matter. But, you know, for this test, I think it's fine. You can't really, it doesn't really affect what it looks like. as far as what I've told, because I've already put these up and already kind of looked at them and compared and got some video footage going. And now this is the screen, and because it's a lot lighter, it's kind of hard to tell some of the like fibers and stuff. You can kind of see them there a little bit, but yeah, but that's the canvas, that's not the paint. But overall, like this dried great. There's I don't see any streaking at all in it. I've looked at it at all angles and I just don't really see anything. It went on really well. I'm definitely doing that second coat. Was a good idea. So anyway, we'll go ahead and set these up. And you'll have to forgive my janky setup, but it's what I could do. And again, on this recording, I've got the exposure on my camera set to what my eyes see, you know, not looking through the video like on my phone camera, but like actually looking at the screen itself. It's matched to where this is the accurate amount of brightness. I did go ahead and pull up, this is our projector that we're using. It is discontinued. I'm not sure why we bought it like last year. You know, they obviously come out with new models and whatnot, but like I said, it is a 6,000 lumen, 3 LCD laser projector. And if you want to see it, it is right here. So, all right, we'll go ahead and set these up. We'll put the Black Widow up first. I apologize if I'm not holding the camera just right. So, obviously, right out of the gate, yeah, you do get a little more contrast with the Black Widow, but I mean, that's a pretty bright image. And this is extremely dark. That, I mean, it's almost, I mean, illegible. I mean, you really just kind of lose everything. I mean, it does. I mean, you obviously definitely more contrast, but it's the contrast is so dark that you just don't even really see what you're looking at. You can kind of see textures, but, you know, compared to just an overall white screen that, yeah, it is kind of washed out on the white and it gets darker here. It's just too dark. Let me go ahead and set Crow's screen up. Set this up without it falling over. All right. So immediately, there's such a massive difference here. So I've already been kind of looking at this, doing different videos. I ran videos of things that we display here in the church, and then I'm, you know, doing some YouTube videos. And one thing that I was telling my wife that I noticed on a lot of the videos that I see Kenneth Bird doing, it's like these OLED videos. And granted, you know, he may have done some other ones, but all the ones that I've seen that he seems to always be doing in all his tests, they're like OLED image type of videos. And when I say, you know, when I'm talking OLED, obviously, you know, we're talking, they're very high contrast videos with a lot of blacks and then a lot of bright, vibrant neon colors. Which is fine, but, you know, not everybody watches 4K OLED videos all day. We watch things with, you know, brightness all over the screen, not just in certain points. So I think with, you know, his darker paint, it helps kind of accentuate the blacks in, like, you know, say like an OLED TV or whatever, like where you've got a lot of black on screen, but then just a little bit of color pop here and there. And I don't know if there's, you know, camera manipulation, but I'm sure there probably is a little bit, but I don't know. I don't, that's not something I'm going to watch. Like, we're going to watch, you know, Netflix, you know, different movies and YouTube videos and whatnot. But, you know, comparing the two, obviously with Crows, it's a silver screen paint, and it does bring your brightness down just a little bit, but, you know, anything other than white, I think, is going to do that. Like, that's just what it is. But everything is legible on his screen. I still see the colors. I still get a fair bit of brightness. The whites do drop a little bit, but not like that. I mean, this honestly looks like I went to Walmart or Home Depot or Lowe's and I just got black paint and painted something. And then I'm trying to cast a projected image on top of it. I you know, you just don't really see anything with this. But, like, you look over at Crows, you know, you get more contrast. You can see a lot more between this white screen and his image, or, you know, his paint. It's a lot better. The only thing I would say as far as my thoughts on Crow's paint, personally, me, for like this screen, this environment, I'd say maybe if it was a shade or two lighter, it would probably be better for us. But I think this mix right here might probably work for my dad's, that 91-inch screen that I was going to paint and give to my dad. I think this is probably going to do the trick. So, and you can also quickly show you the projector settings. And pretty much this is all default other than the brightness. This is what we're running. This is what looks the best for us on the screen that we have now, and we've not really changed anything. Let's see, let me go, if I can do this while holding a camera. On the image, nope, not that one. Escape. Color mode, sorry, I was on it. We're on the presentation. I've went through all these and I don't like how any of these other ones look. The presentation one looks the best for us. The multi-projection setting is okay, but presentation seemed to be the brightest image. Okay, there we go. So yeah, there, I mean, that's kind of a good shot right there. You know, you get a lot more contrast with the silver compared to, well, I mean, you get better contrast compared to the white screen, but, like, it's just overly contrasted on the Black Widow. Kind of want to feel like I need to keep talking, but then also probably should just kind of be quiet and just let you see the video. So yeah, like right there at the edge of that little sandbar there, it's really kind of hard to make out what it is on the white screen, but, you know, over here on Crow's screen, you can make it out more clearly.
So anyway, I think that we'll kind of wrap that up. You know, Crow, this is kind of for you, and I really like your screen paint. I think this is probably, like I said, I think this mix that you sent me is what I'd like to use for my dad on his screen. So I'll probably, you know, I'll hit you up about ordering some more of that, so I've got enough to do that screen, because I'm going to have to, because it's painted black with the Black Widow now, so I'm going to have to prime it and then probably do two or three coats of your paint mix to get that one done. So yeah, I'm very happy with the way Crow's turned out. But again, like I said, I think for if we were going to go with that for in here on this screen, I'd probably maybe do just a shade or two lighter, but no more than that, because I think if you went any lighter, it kind of defeat the purpose of like what we would be shooting for, which is to knock back some of the ambient light and still retain you know, your contrast with your darks and your textures and all that. So thanks for watching, and I'll go ahead and end this and hopefully get this all cut together and sent your way today. Later.